Well, the days are growing darker and colder. Time to make a literal cut. Oh, this right there is the harvest from number 8, set out to dry and to sort out the bad berries. Because number 1, number 4 and number 6 have almost no more fruits on them, they will be cut first. And cut! This is all I picked off of them, or found on the floor next to them. That red fruit probably does not even belong to 6, but it just rolled over there. Number 5 is still at work producing fruits, as is my beloved number 8. Numbers 2, 3 and 7 have some fruits left to produce too. But fast forward from October to November and they are right next in line. In fact, I will chop down the whole rest of the plantation today. I am a huge fan of the Desert Planet franchise, so let me paraphrase Dune. Arrakis teaches the attitude of the knife. Cutting off what's incomplete and saying, now it's complete, because it ends here. This is what I plucked off while cutting down. In order to have an idea of what could have been, I also took off all the green fruits that showed no sign of changing color yet. Or at least nearly all. I left those on the steam as a marker. Because it took me a few days before taking photos of the berries, they took on some orange or red in the meantime. I will discard those, however. Anyway. With number 5, it is of note that there were quite a few Siamese fruits, so to speak, which I took off separately in the sleeve at the right top corner there. I encountered such conjoined berries a few times during the development of my Caryolochia line, but never this many at the same time and on the same plant. Number 7 put out few fruits, but at least all of them managed to ripen.
And that's the rest of number 8.